Hey everyone, I just want to talk about something that also is an obstacle and makes us uncomfortable in our HR careers. And that is when you've got someone in the organization that it's really, really hard to get along with. And I've had several of these because I've got a strong personality and I tend to defend myself. And I think that's what we all have to do. If someone treats you disrespectfully, call them on that behavior. That's different from simple disagreements. It's different from, I just can't agree with you. I'm not going to do what you ask. It's more like when behavior gets out of control and people start displaying their anger or disrespect or start doing things that are there to just simply undermine you instead of helping you to be a team member and helping you to succeed in the organization by at least hearing you out. So let me give you an example. There was a woman I worked with who she was a colleague in HR, but we never got to a point where we really agreed with each other, even though she did agree to hire me in. but we spent the next 3 or 4 years arguing. And, you know, a lot of those times it was just a personality difference in how we saw a situation and how we were going to proceed. But at one point I wouldn't agree with something that just didn't work with the people I supported. And she got so frustrated, she slammed my door and ran off to her own office. And that struck me as pretty juvenile behavior. And so I said, I'm just going to have to call her on this. So went to her office and asked her about slamming my door and told her I didn't feel like that was a respectful way to treat me and that I think we needed to talk about it further. I said, I'm going to set up a meeting and I'll invite the people who we report to and we're just going to talk about it. And that's what I did. I've had a couple of meetings this way where I've had to say, you know, you can't come into my office, yell at me, slam the door, be a bully. That's not how we work in this department. It's not how we work in this organization. And so I tend to get help when that happens and just talk about the behavior itself. It's not the underlying problem that caused the argument. It's the behavior that it's spun into, right? And that's what I want to make sure that, you don't deserve to be treated that way. I didn't deserve to be treated that way. What I did deserve was a conversation where we listen to each other and we work out our conflict. Okay, so that's what I've always wanted out of the situation. So sometimes you might need some help to get you through that and get to a point where you can work respectfully, because there's really not much of a worse problem or feeling of having someone who just kind of glares at you when you walk by. Obviously, you're not going to get much done in an organization and you're working on the same team or even in teams that should be working really well together. So my recommendation is call the people on it, get some support in and see what you can do to make sure that people understand that their behavior that is bad behavior in the workplace is just not acceptable. So it's going to make you feel better to deal with it head on. And actually, research shows you that with women, the best way to keep yourself in a great perception of power and a perception of strength is to defend yourself against things that are unreasonable. And unreasonable behavior includes slamming your door, walking out of a meeting, you know, things like that, things that show that there's a lack of respect or at least a lack of restraint. Okay, so if you're wondering what's going on outside, the coloring of the sky is odd today. We all woke up in California with orange skies, and it's the sun trying to shine through smoke, fog all together, and the light is very strange outside. It definitely smells like smoke outside. We're definitely hoping for an end to these fires and sort of a return to clearer, more healthy air. I do want to just mention that I am going live on Facebook on Friday morning at 10 a.m. Pacific time, and I'm going over a webinar I've given lots and lots of times. It's simply about how to advance in your HR career. Okay, so look for the link and definitely try and show up if you can. Have a great day.